Hello and good morning, friends. Welcome to the CEC EDUSET Live Lecture. Dear friends, as you know that we are carrying a series on social, economic and cultural perspectives of the films of different filmmakers. We have discussed on films by different filmmakers. Today we would be discussing specifically on films of Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and we would be trying to get the social, cultural and economic perspective. And for this discussion, we have again with us in our studios Dr. Manoj Sharma. Dr. Manoj Sharma is an assistant professor in Department of History, Kirodi Mal College, University of Delhi. So first of all, I would like to welcome our guest, Dr. Manoj Sharma, under whose guidance we would be discussing on Hrishikesh Mukherjee. Hello sir, welcome to the EDUSET Lecture.
Very good morning to all the viewers. Today's topic of discussion is socio-economic and cultural perspectives in the films of Hrishikesh Mukherjee. As we have already talked about the different filmmakers of different eras, that how through their cinema they try to portray the socio-economic aspects of the society as well as the kind of culture which was rooted in the society as well. So Hrishikesh Mukherjee, who started his career as an editor of cinema along with Bimal Roy, he edited some of the films of Bimal Roy, and later on he turned his attention to direction and the kind of cinema which he made. He made more than 40 films. He was also the chairman of CBFC, Central Board of Film Certification, and at the same time he also received the Dada Saheb Phalke Award, which is considered to be the highest award which is related to the cinema. So the contribution of Hrishikesh Mukherjee in the context that the kind of cinema which he made, which is generally categorized as a middle cinema in the context that it was not dealing only with the kind of art cinema which was dealing with stark realism, and at the same time this cinema which was a middle cinema, it was not only dealing with the kind of cinema which was there, the two kinds of things which were there during this particular period was that the commercial cinema as well as the other kind of cinema which was the realist cinema. Both these kind of films, some sort of a middle way was found by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. His films, they were dealing with a number of themes or aspects. One of the themes related to the kind of family unity. It also related to the issue of national integration, in the sense that some of the films they were talking about the idea of nation building, and at the same time the focus of many of his films was on middle class values, the kind of middle class values which are there in 1960s, 70s and 80s, and these kind of values they were being reflected in many of the films which were made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. For example, Anand was one, then Mili was another, Golmaal, Khoobsurat, so Chupke Chupke, these were some of the films which became quite popular. And at the same time, the theme of life and death, which was quite there in many of the films which were made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. For example, Mili, Anand, they deal with this kind of aspect. And the first film which was also made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee was also based on this theme. So what we have seen over the years, that how Hrishikesh Mukherjee evolved as a filmmaker, and at the same time the idea of socio-economic perspectives which were not only related to the society of those times, but at the same time many of the issues which were relevant or universal for all times. The idea of life and death, and how life is a stage, as it was reflected in a film called Anand, they were being reflected in the cinema of Hrishikesh Mukherjee. So today we will discuss the kind of films which he made, the kind of undercurrents in the films, and at the same time the kind of message which he tried to give to the society through his cinema. As I have already told you, that his cinema was some sort of a middle cinema, and Gulzar et al., they have also written a book called Encyclopedia of Hindi Cinema, in which they have talked about this aspect, that this cinema which was a middle cinema and which appealed to the middle class audience of those times. So first film which I would like to talk about is Musafir, which was made in 1957, and this was the directorial debut of Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and it was about a house in the lives of three families who live in it, and three stories they were linked by this house, and The three episodes which are generally being shown in the film, they relate to the stories of marriage, birth and death. And how this idea of man is a musafir or traveler in life was reflected in this film. So this film deals with the issue that ultimate truth is death. So as we, all of us in real lives also, we consider death as imminent, but at the same time we do not think about our own death. So similarly, but finally what actually happens is that when we visit cremation grounds, there we realize that this is the ultimate truth. And when we come out of that place, then again we are again involved in the materialistic lifestyle. So this film, which was talking about three stories of three different families, and all these three different families, they come and occupy one single house. And that house basically narrates the stories of marriage, birth and death. And through these three stories, Hrishikesh Mukherjee offers some kind of philosophy of life and death, that how a life which is there, it is to be lived, and at the same time we have to realize that life is very transient kind of a thing. It is not for eternity, and death is a truth which is to be realized at some point of life. So these were some kind of ideas which were also reflected in many other films which were made by him. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Anadi, which was made by him with Raj Kapoor in the lead. And this film was also considered to be an important aspect, that it was a commercial film, and it also got some kind of success at the box office, as Musafir was not all that successful. So this film, in which Raj Kapoor acted as an honest man, and honesty basically is seen to be some sort of an anadipan in the sense that Raj Kapoor believes or is being shown in the film as an anadi, because he is trying to be as honest as possible. And in the contemporary times, specifically in 50s and 60s, and this kind of honesty was getting rarer and rarer. So this kind of issue was being raised by Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and how Raj Kapoor gets involved, in the sense that spurious medicines, they were being sold by the company in which he was working, and how he gets involved in that. Finally, he is proved innocent also. And there is a song also, Sab Kuch Sikha Humne Na Sikhi Hoshiari. So Hoshiari is basically dishonesty. And this is what the film also talks about or tries to narrate as well. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Anuradha, which was made in 1960. Anuradha was a film in which Balraj Sahani is shown as a committed doctor to serve humanity, and Leela Naidu is noted radio singer, dancer and a rich heiress. Balraj Sahani lives life of service, commitment and justice for poor villages. Leela Naidu, she marries him and she also joins him. She has a number of problems in living a simple life in a village. And finally, she adjusts in settling with husband for good. So this was one theme which was taken by Hrishikesh Mukherjee, in which what we see is that Balraj Sahani was playing a committed doctor, how he was trying to bring some kind of justice to the poor villagers, and how a girl who was besotted by him, who marries him and decides to migrate or move to the village. And when she moves to the village, what actually happens is that she faces a lot of problems, because she was living an urban lifestyle, and suddenly she has to come to a lifestyle in which a number of things which were not available to her, which were available to her earlier in an urban setting, they were not being available to her in the rural area. And how she is also being given an option by her husband, that if she is not able to adjust to that kind of lifestyle, she can go back to the urban setting, and there she can lead her life. But finally, she decides that she has to stay with her husband. And this is what the film tries to show in the context, that when once a woman has got married and in a way tied to a man, then she has to follow the kind of lifestyle that man has. So the kind of traditional values of the society in which marriage is some sort of a thing which was considered to be sacred, which cannot be dissolved in any manner, and how a wife is tied to a man forever, to a husband forever. So these kind of ideas, they were being reflected in this particular film. Another film which I like to talk about is Ashirwad, which was made in 1968. And this film starred Ashok Kumar, and how an emotional journey of a man is being shown in the film, who stood by his principles, was also reflected in this cinema. And when this man accidentally kills a person so that he could protect a girl who was to be molested by that particular man, and he is also being shielded by the people, those who have witnessed this kind of incident, but he refuses that he is ready to accept the punishment, and he finally accepts his crime in the court. He refuses to speak untruth, and at the same time he is also suggesting that the others should not speak untruth so that he could be saved. And in this film, what we see is that the first time Ashok Kumar sang a rap song, Rail Gadi, Rail Gadi. So that kind of song is considered to be the first rap song of India, though it was not notified in that genre. But nowadays, how rap has become popular, so the kind of initiation of these kind of rap songs could be seen in this particular film. And there is another song by Manna Day in which he says, Jeevan se lambe hai bandhu, jeevan ke raaste. So this film is also talking about this kind of aspect, that how life which is to be lived by an individual has a number of challenges, and one has to one has to overcome those kind of challenges by the kind of ideals which one has in one's own life. And one, when one will be able to overcome these kind of challenges, then only one will become victorious for the kind of ideals or the principles in which one believes. With regard to this particular aspect, there was another film called Satyakam, which was made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. And this film is considered to be one of the finest works of actor Dharmendra, in which he has acted, though he could not receive many awards in his lifetime. But when one sees the film, one is able to realize that this film was one of the important milestones in the career of Dharmendra. And Sharmila Tagore and Sanjeev Kumar, both of them, they also acted in this film. And the film basically begins in the year 1946. Thereafter, Dharmendra, who is there, who becomes an engineer over a period of time, he has all those kind of dreams in which he wants to transform India. He wants to contribute to the idea of nation building. And he makes his own contribution in the sense that he is a very truthful person. He is not ready to compromise in his life. And at the same time, there is another society which is being shown, where people are dishonest. And he is considered to be a person who is unfit for such kind of a society. But at the same time, the kind of obstinacy which is being shown by Dharmendra in the film, that he is obstinate till the end, he is not ready to compromise till the end. Finally, when he wants to compromise also, he is being dissuaded in this way by his own wife. So this kind of some kind of a paradigm shift which takes place during this particular period, the idea of growth is being represented in the film. And an engineer in the form of Dharmendra, when he ventures out to realize his dream about building a new India, that has also been shown in this particular film. But at the same time, there are others who are not able to share the kind of ideas which Dharmendra has. And what we also see, that the female protagonist, the role played by Sharmila Tagore in the film, she is being seduced by a morally corrupt prince who is the employer of Dharmendra also. And Dharmendra is not able to save her from this kind of calamity which falls on her. And this incident, though he could have done it, he felt that this was some sort of a situation which he avoids, and this shakes the ethical foundation of the character played by Dharmendra, who feels that he has betrayed his conscience and feelings. And what actually happens that and to overcome this kind of conscience, the kind of guilt which he has developed when he was not able to save that girl, he finally marries that girl, Sharmila Tagore, so that he could come out of his guilt. But at the same time, she is also making an attempt to come out of her past, which was not all that good, because the kind of problem which she encountered while she was living in the palace of that prince, and the kind of relations which she developed with Dharmendra. So this kind of complexity in the relationships, this kind of problems in terms of human relationships was very well documented by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. And at the same time, what happens is that the couple also have some kind of a marital problems as well. This kind of marital discord or problems which are being encountered in everybody, in every marriage, they were also being evident. And this was compounded by the fact that Dharmendra knew her past, and at the same time, she was also trying to do away with her past. So these kind of problems, they were being also encountered. And what actually happens is that when a child is born, the paternity of the child is not really established, whether Dharmendra is the father or the other person who had seduced is the father. So this kind of question is not being settled, and this also becomes some kind of a thorn in their relationship, though it is not being overtly said, but the undercurrents of such kind of dilemma of the couple is generally there. And Dharmendra plays the role of an honest person, and because of his honesty, he has to change jobs quite frequently because he is not ready to compromise in his life. And at the same time, this brings some kind of problems in their lives as well, because the changing of jobs also brings the kind of change in their lifestyle, and at the same time, the change of place as well. Finally, what happens is that Dharmendra develops some kind of a fatal illness, and he is being bedridden. And when he is being bedridden, what kind of future will await Sharmila Tagore and their son? And what they have to do is to find some kind of a solution, but he does not have any kind of solution because he did not amass any kind of wealth by any corrupt means. And finally, he gets a chance also when he signs one of the contracts with one of the contractors, then he will be given some kind of money by that contractor, so that his wife and the kid, they will live in a very comfortable position forever after his death. And he also signs that documents, but when that document is being given by him to his wife Sharmila Tagore, she tears the documents, and in a way, when Dharmendra smiles in the film, it is some kind of an attestation that he is able to convert one person to his kind of ideals. And when he dies, his grandfather, the role being played by Ashok Kumar, who is some sort of a spiritual person who is reading various scriptures, he comes and he refuses to share any kind of responsibility of his grandson's wife and the kid, and he wants to go without taking their responsibility. And the child of Dharmendra and Sharmila Tagore publicly speaks out, saying that the real reason is that grandfather is unsure of his paternity, the child's paternity. So this kind of a truth, when spoken by a child, this kind of a truth when is being realized by the granddaughter-in-law, the grandfather is humbled by this kind of a situation, that a child knows about this kind of an issue, and child has that kind of courage where the child is speaking about this kind of a truth in a public space, which not only will make uncomfortable situation for the child and the mother, but at the same time, it will lead to some kind of a taunt in their lives, and they will also face some kind of a humiliation for the rest of their lives. So the grandfather realizes that there are many facets of the truth. Truth is not unidimensional, it is not one-dimensional, rather it is multidimensional in nature. And this multidimensional nature of the truth was not being recognized by the grandfather, though he was, though he has read a number of his scriptures. So this kind of a realization by him at that point of time, he decides that he will take both the child and the mother along with them. He realizes his own failings or weaknesses, and also tries that he will try to learn more about the truth in the future. And this could also be related in the context that by 1960s, a lot of disillusionment in the society had also come, because India became independent in 1947. There was a lot of hope and inertia. And how these hopes will lead to some kind of a good ending for the people, those who had been exploited during the colonial rule. But even after around 20 years, the kind of problems which Indians were facing, they were not being addressed by the various governments which had taken over a period of time, and the kind of problems of the people, they had multiplied. There were a number of unemployment issues, the issues of poverty, issues of scarcity of food resources. All these kind of basic problems of people with regard to food, shelter, education, etc., they were not being fulfilled. And some kind of disenchantment had set in. So this kind of disenchantment was also a result of the kind of corruption which was there in the society. And all these kind of problems with which the people were not able to relate, they could be understood in this framework. That a person who is considered to be an honest person is not able to find some kind of a suitable place for himself in the society, and he is considering himself to be a person who is basically an unfit person in that particular society. Another film which I would like to talk about is Anand, which was made in 1971, in which Amitabh Bachchan plays the role of Dr. Bhaskar, and he has written a book with the title of Anand, and the story moves in a flashback mode where he recounts his own experiences of a person named Anand. And this person is being suffering from an intestinal cancer which was incurable, and how this person, played by Rajesh Khanna, he is basically a very happy-go-lucky kind of a person who is trying to bring all kind of cheers in the lifestyle of other persons. And how this person, despite knowing that he will not live for quite long, despite that fact, he is ready to accept life as it comes. He is not being bothered about his death, because death basically is an imminent aspect of life of an individual. And how also this person, played by Rajesh Khanna, tries to bring some kind of happiness to the life of Amitabh Bachchan, because Amitabh Bachchan is being shown as an introvert, and he is not being able to express his feelings for a girl whom he treated. And how Rajesh Khanna is instrumental in bringing them close. And Hanif Zaveri, he argues that the role of in the film Anand, the central role was to be played by Kishore Kumar. And when Kishore Kumar and Mahmood, they were to play these kind of roles which are played by Rajesh Khanna and Amitabh Bachchan, and when they could not find the dates, then both these actors, they were being taken up. So this film basically also talks about the idea or the philosophy of life, and at the same time how death is the ultimate truth, and how the people, those who have taken birth in the lives, they are just the characters on a larger stage in the world, which is the stage, and how the stage of the theater, and how these characters, those who have taken birth, they have to portray or they have to depict their roles. And this has been made clear also through a dialogue where Rajesh Khanna is explicitly talking about this dialogue. And when this dialogue is being recorded, and finally that same dialogue is again repeated in the end as well, that how the world is a stage, and the various characters, those who have come on the earth, they are basically certain characters, those who have to depict or portray life. So these are the kind of ideas they were being shown in the film. Anand had a number of songs which were also talking about the various kind of ideas which were there in the film. They were taking the film forward. Zindagi kaisi hai paheli hai, kahin dur jab din dhal jaye. These were the two songs which in a way summarized the philosophy of the entire film. And both the songs, they also add to the mood of the film as well. They take the story forward. And this film was given the National Film Award in 1971. And it was the best feature film in Hindi. It also received the best Filmfare Award in 1972. So this film was an important film in the career of Rajesh Khanna as well as Amitabh Bachchan, who had till yet not become the angry young man, the kind of image he developed after Zanjeer and Deewar in 1973-75 onwards. And before that, he was trying to play certain characters. And another film which I'd like to talk about is Guddi, which was made in 1971, in which Jaya Bahaduri plays the role of a school girl who is obsessed with actor Dharmendra, and she is not able to distinguish between the on-screen image and the real person behind the star. And the solution in the film was shown that how Guddi is being made to realize the difference between the illusion and reality. And with the help of Dharmendra, which was taken by Utpal Dutt, who plays the role of a professor, Guddi is being shown the difference between the real world and the make-believe world of the film. So what we see is that so many people, they were fascinated with the films even now, and during that particular period, so many people, they fled from their homes, and they had these kind of dreams in their eyes that the kind of characters which they were seeing on the screen, they were the real characters, and they fled from their home so that they could meet them, they could marry them for that person, and that person whom they adored was basically the same person as he was on the screen. But on the other hand, the kind of characters these film stars or actresses they portrayed on the screen, they might be totally different from their real persona. So this kind of distinction was being shown in this particular film, that how Guddi is being exposed to the grime and the cruel world which was behind the camera. And she is being made to realize in the film that nothing is true in the real world. So the kind of distinction between the real world and the real world was being shown in this film, and how her respect for Dharmendra in the film, who plays as Dharmendra in the film, grows. And she realizes that Dharmendra was also just a human being as others were, and he was also living with the same kind of fears and insecurities as others had. So this kind of film, which was talking about these kind of aspects, which was trying to distinguish between the real world and the real world, was also shown in the film which was made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. And what we also see is that he also tried to make some kind of a cinema which was dealing with the human or the everyday problems which are there in the family. One film which he made was Bawarchi, with Rajesh Khanna in the lead. And in this film, some kind of a family discord is being shown, that the various persons in a family, how they have some kind of a suspicion or distrust of each other. And this kind of suspicion or distrust did not have any kind of basis. Rather, their own selfish motives or selfish ideas or narrow-mindedness with regard to their responsibility led to some kind of a problems amongst themselves. And when a person played by Rajesh Khanna as some sort of a cook, and when he enters the house, he realizes that this kind of a house also had similar kind of problems which are there in other houses as well. And he tries to bring them together, and when he tries to bring them together, he has to remove their misunderstandings as well. and the male patriarch of the house, he also becomes close to Rajesh Khanna in the film. And the other characters, they are also being helped by Rajesh Khanna, that how he is adept at different arts, not only cooking, but at the same time he is a good singer and a dancer, and the other kind of skills which he says that he has acquired when he was working as a domestic help to some famous personalities, and because of which he had that kind of a varied experience. And how the members of the house, they are being benefited by the kind of knowledge which Rajesh Khanna has. And when this film was being shown to the audience, they were able to relate to the kind of story, and it was also quite successful at the commercial level. It was some sort of a box office hit, and it could also generate a lot of revenue for the filmmaker. And this was also in a way reflective of the idea of family, that how the joint families, they were having a number of problems, and how these joint families, they were to be saved by the people, those who were the part of their family, when they will develop these kind of values, where they have respect for each other, where they have faith for each other, and at the same time, they also feel some kind of responsibility to do something for the younger ones in the family. And at the same time, the elder ones in the family, they are to be respected. So these kind of ideas, they were being reflected in this particular film. And how finally, in the end, Rajesh Khanna, he acknowledges that actually he was a professor, and his name was Professor Prabhakar. But how he had seen, as you can see on the screen as well, that how he was feeling dissatisfied with such kind of families, such kind of divided families, and he wanted to use his knowledge to stop this kind of phenomena. And the inspiration for this film was another film which was made by David Dhawan with the title of Hero Number 1 in 1997, in which Govinda acted the central part. So that film borrowed a lot from Bawarchi, because the main plot of the story, apart from the different setting, could be seen in this particular film. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Abhiman, which was made in 1973. Abhiman basically was dealing with the issue of husband and wife. It was dealing with the human relationships, that how some kind of an ego or misunderstanding between the husband and wife led to that kind of a marital discord, which was shown in Abhiman. It was also being suggested that Jaya Bahaduri basically was more successful than Amitabh Bachchan when this film was being made, and it was showing their lifestyle. But it was suggested by another scholar that the film related to the story of Kishore Kumar and his first wife Roma. And what we see in the film is that Amitabh Bachchan is being shown as a successful singer, and he goes to the village, and when he goes to the village of his native place, he finds a girl who is a good singer, played by Jaya Bahaduri, and how they finally marry. And when they marry, and Jaya Bahaduri comes to the city, at one of the places, she is also being allowed, or she is also being asked to sing. And when she sings, her potential in terms of singing is being realized by the people, those who were from the singing fraternity. And when her potential is being realized, she is being asked to sing. And what we see is that the career graph of Jaya Bahaduri is going up, and on the other hand, the career graph of the role played by Amitabh Bachchan is going down. So this hurts the male pride, and when this male pride or male ego is hurt, this brings a lot of marital problems in their life. And it also shows the issue of the comparative skills in the lives of a couple, the husband and wife, and how when they are from the same field of fraternity, it brings the problem is compounded. And at the same time, it also talks about the position of women in the society as well, that how women, despite their potential which is on a higher notch, they are being in a way given some kind of a secondary position in the society. They are trying to, as Jaya Bahaduri was ready to in a way compromise in her life, she is ready to in a way give her position of a good singer. She is not ready to compete with her husband. She goes back to her village again. This was shown in this particular film. So the position of the women in the society in the context that she is ready to compromise in life, and at the same time she is ready to sacrifice that her family life should not suffer, and prospect of a better professional career. She is ready to sacrifice her professional career for her personal life. So that was being shown in this particular film. Raju Bharthan, a film scholar, he has talked about this, and he says that the film basically talks about the lives of Kishore Kumar and his first wife Roma, and the two songs in the film, Ab To Hai Tumse Har Khushi Apni and Piya Bina, both the songs, they are also again talking about the issues which are related to males, that how the male ego is to be propitiated or satisfied by the women, and how they form the integral part of their lives. That has also been shown in the film. One film which I like to talk about is Namak Haram, which was made in 1973, and in this film Rajesh Khanna and Amitabh Bachchan, they came together. Rajesh Khanna was a bigger star at that point of time, and Amitabh Bachchan had not made his mark as an angry young man at that point of time. And he plays the role of a rich man's son who has to fight a union leader. And how Rajesh Khanna, who plays the part of the friend of Amitabh Bachchan, he decides to help his friend. And he says that he will go as some sort of a trade union person to that trade union, and he will try to gel with those people, and at the same time he will try to disintegrate or bring some kind of division to that trade union, which was against the industrialist played by Amitabh Bachchan. And when he goes there, he is able to relate with the kind of people, those who were there. He tries to understand the kind of problems these people they encountered in their lifestyle. And though he initially went as some sort of a breaker of the union, but finally he becomes a person who strengthens the union more. He becomes their leader. And this kind of a conflict in terms of the class distinctions which were there in the society was also being shown in the film, that it was being shown that Rajesh Khanna becomes some sort of a betrayer. But finally the question is that who was the betrayer, whether Rajesh Khanna, who was asking for the rights of the people, Rajesh Khanna, who was fighting for the justice for the people, those who were working in the factories, or Amitabh Bachchan in the film, who plays an industrialist and who is not ready to give the due which was to be given to the workers, those who were working in their factories. So these kind of ideas which were talking about the class distinctions, which were giving some kind of a message to the people, they were also being shown in the films which were made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and such kind of a theme was also being used by Prakash Jha in one of the later films in which Abhay Deol was being sent in the field of the Naxalites, and he tries to know about the secrets of the Naxalites so that he can help his friend played by Arjun Rampal. So some kind of an inspiration was being taken from this particular film, which was made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee. And another film which I'd like to talk about is Mili, which was made in 1975, in which the central figure played by Jaya Bahaduri, who suffers from a pernicious anemia, which was considered untreatable during those times. And she is a very energetic, inquisitive and jovial girl who is trying to spread some kind of happiness in everybody's life. And how her relationship with Amitabh is being shown in the film, and how both of them, they get married, and Amitabh Bachchan takes her abroad for treatment. So here again, the philosophy of life, where death is an ultimate truth, but at the same time, life is to be lived. And how that life is to be lived? That life is to be lived by making all sorts of compromises in the life. But at the same time, one does not have to get distressed and disheartened in the sense that one should not become pessimistic towards life. One has to fight the challenges of the life was also shown in this film. And this film was appreciated by the audience at all levels. And it also was quite successful at the box office. When you try to compare Anand and Mili, you will find that the central philosophy of both the films was similar. And in Anand, Rajesh Khanna is the central character, and Mili, Jaya Bachchan plays the central part. And at the both levels, one was a male-centric view, another was a female-centric view. And at both the points, the filmmaker, who is considered to be the author of the film, is trying to make this point that how the ultimate truth or the death should be realized by the people, those who are there. And at the same time, they have to make all sorts of adjustments in their own lives. So that was the central theme of Mili. Another film which I'd like to talk about is Chupke Chupke, which was made in 1975, in which Dharmendra is being shown as a botany professor. And when Dharmendra is being shown as a botany professor, it was a light-hearted comedy, and which was showing the middle class values and how he feels jealous of his wife's brother-in-law, who is being praised quite often by his wife, and he decides that he will go and he will dupe him, in the sense that he will not be able to recognize him when he will go there. And he disguises himself as a driver, and when he goes there, all sorts of situational comedy takes place. And the brother-in-law, played by Om Prakash, is not able to realize that the role played by that Dharmendra, who has come as a driver to his own house, is actually his brother-in-law. So this kind of a situation, in which there is a lot of comedy, where there is no violence in the film, there is no obscenity in the film, there is no cheap comedy in the film. Rather, all the comedy which comes out is very situational in nature. And at the same time, what we also see is that the kind of values with regard to the familial matters, they are also being shown in the film. And this film became quite successful, and Dharmendra was portrayed as some sort of a comic hero for the first time, and he was able to do all sorts of justice to the role in which he was taken. And another film which I'd like to talk about, which was in the similar vein, was Golmaal, which was made in 1979, and it is considered to be one of the finest comedies of its times. And it also tries to portray that the clothes and mustache, which is being taken as some sort of a symbol to define people, are not the real indicators. And the middle class values and the sensibility, they are being reflected. It was also a light-hearted romance, and a lot of situational comedy was also integrated. It was not any kind of over-the-top comedy or cheap comedy which was shown in this film. So what we see is that the kind of cinema which was made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee was arguing for these kind of aspects, that we should not try to identify people on the basis of their clothes. We should not try to identify people whether they keep any mustache or beard, as it was shown in the film that Utpal Dutt, who plays a kind of character in the film, has this kind of prejudice that the people, those who have mustache, they are more honest in nature, and the people, those who do not keep any kind of mustache, they are not to be trusted. And finally, in the end, he also shaves his own mustache. This kind of a message is being given in the film, that one should not have any kind of prejudice in their lives. And all these kind of prejudice, they should be done away with. Another film within the same kind of idea was Khoobsurat, which was made in 1980, in which Rekha plays the central character. And in this, Dina Pathak plays the role of a strict disciplinarian, and Ashok Kumar is shown to be her husband. And how the entire family is being disciplined by Dina Pathak, who plays the role of a female patriarch in the sense. And how Rekha, who comes to their house because she is the sister of the daughter-in-law of the house, and when she comes there, she realizes that because she was not all that a person who was ready to follow all the rules of the life, she was comparatively an outgoing person. And when she befriends all the members of the house, because she is very playful and naughty in nature, and Dina Pathak is not able, was not ready to in any way trust Rekha in the film, because she feels that Rekha is not that sort of a person. She is not that kind of a girl who is more responsible. But finally what happens is that when Ashok Kumar gets heart attack, Rekha manages the house. And when she manages the house in such a manner, in a very responsible way, then Dina Pathak, she realizes her own mistake, and she accepts the fact that she was more responsible. So the idea is the idea of a female patriarch, and how the values of the family, they should be there in the family, and how women, they are being categorized in the context of good behavior or bad behavior. When a girl is being shown who is more play loving, one who is more jovial, then she is not a good girl in that sense. So these kind of ideas, they are being rejected, that Rekha playing a character of a playful girl, but she is at the same time more traditional in nature. She is also more responsible, she is more respectful. So all kinds of rules, all kinds of disciplines which are there in a family should not be shown in that way, that they become some sort of a threat to the family itself. The members, they should be given all sorts of freedom in the family. They should be able to freely express their viewpoints and thoughts with each other. They are able to relate with each other. Then only families, they will be able to save each other. So the question of the responsibility of a woman, how that responsibility should not be seen in the way they behave in the family, but at the same time how they are able to relate with the family members was shown in this film. Another film which I like to talk about is Naram Garam, which was made in 1981. It starred Swaroop Sampath, Amol Palekar, Utpal Dutt and Chaturan Sinha. Amol Palekar, he helped Swaroop Sampath and her father to provide some kind of a shelter. Later, Chaturan Sinha and Utpal Dutt also desire to marry her. And finally, Amol Palekar marries after a salary raise and house. So what we see is that it was also a light-hearted kind of a comedy, in which Amol Palekar, who is being employed by Utpal Dutt, and Swaroop Sampath plays the love interest of Amol Palekar, and how she is being in a way wanted or desired by Utpal Dutt as well as Chaturan Sinha. Both of them, they want to marry her. And finally, Amol Palekar is able to create that kind of a situation in which Utpal Dutt is being forced to marry Swaroop Sampath to Amol Palekar. So this film was also talking about some sort of a situational comedy, and at the same time it was also trying to portray the kind of village life which was there in 1970s, 1980s of a particular area. And at the same time, another film called Kisi Se Na Kehna, which was made in 1983. In which Utpal Dutt is being shown as a person who has some kind of a prejudice against westernized girls or women. And he is not ready to marry his son, Farooq Sheikh, to a girl who is shown as some sort of a westernized girl. And when Farooq Sheikh decides to marry a doctor played by Deepthi Naval, who is very well educated and who knows English as well. So he is very afraid that how this kind of a proposal where he has to marry a girl who is educated, well versed in English, should go to his father. And his father, who was considered to very traditional and conservative, and who was not ready to marry his son to a girl who was westernized, who knew English, and he only wanted a girl who was more traditional, more conservative in nature. So such kind of a situation is being created where Utpal Dutt is made to believe that the girl whom his son is going to marry is daughter of a priest in a village who does not know the language English, and she is conservative and traditional in all the aspects of her life. And on the other hand, the truth was entirely different. And how they are being helped by his father's friend, played by Saeed Jafri. And this also leads to all kinds of situation in the film, where you will find all sorts of comical situations. But at the same time, this idea of prejudice against a particular set of beliefs or ideas was also rejected in the film, that finally Utpal Dutt agrees that one who is being educated in English, one who is well versed in the Western ideas, is a person who is to be rejected. Rather, he accepts this fact that the education will bring some kind of a maturity to a person, and he also realizes his mistake in the end. He also makes a film in 1982 with the title of Bemisal, in which Amitabh Bachchan was the central figure, and Amitabh Bachchan also plays the role of a doctor in this film, and how he also sacrificed, he is being raised by a family because he becomes some sort of an orphan person, and when he is being raised by that family, he realizes that he has to give something back. And when he repays the debt in the form that he saves the son of the house, played by Vinod Mehra, when he was caught in a medical malpractice. So what we see is that these kind of values which were being diminishing in the society, that people were not ready to repay any kind of debt which they had in some way, not only the monetary debt, rather the debt which they felt in terms of gratitude for the kind of work which has been done by them, done for them by others. So these kind of values, they were being diminishing in the society. So this film talks about those kind of ideals where one has to talk about the values which were there, in the society. Another film was, the last film which was directed by Hrishikesh Mukherjee was Jhoot Bole Kauwa Kaate, in which Anil Kapoor and Juhi Chawla, they played the central characters. This film was not all that successful. It was also a very clean kind of a comedy, but by then the times had changed, and the kind of narration, the kind of treatment of the films, they had taken some kind of, a number of changes had come. But this film was also talking about an aspect that how we have to be honest in life. So that was one value system which was an important value system this film talked about. I'd like to end the discussion by talking about the themes of Hrishikesh Mukherjee's films, that how he talked about the varied themes, the charm of life, as well as the ultimate truth of death, which was there, which was reflected in the cinema, like Musafir, Anand and Mili. At the same time, the kind of class distinctions or conflict which was seen in Namak Haram, as he had shown in the film. Then the kind of comedies which he made, like Golmaal, etc. And the idea of nation building which was shown in Saptakam. So the varied themes, which was talking about the various philosophies of life, they were being reflected in the films which were made by Hrishikesh Mukherjee, and the kind of treatment which he gave to them, because he was film director, but at the same time he also produced a number of films. He was earlier an editor in the films, so he knew the craft of editing. So the kind of films which he made had all kinds of understanding of the various crafts of filmmaking, because he himself was a practitioner of those kind of crafts. And when this kind of a cinema, which was being shown to the audience in 1960s, 70s onwards, they were able to relate with that kind of cinema, because his films, they were talking about those kind of values which were being prevalent in that particular society. With this kind of idea, I'd like to end the discussion. Thank you so much.
With that, we Thank you so very much for giving us a very, very productive session once again. And dear friends, if you have liked this lecture or if you have any kind of feedback or questions which you would like to be answered, then you can mail us at info.cc@nic.in. We would be meeting again very soon. Till then, you can watch these lectures with the help of YouTube. So, I would like to thank Dr. Manoj Sharma once again. Thank you, sir. Thank you so very much.